she's been crying. She's got blisters on the soles of her feet. She can walk, but she's trying. Oh, think twice, 'cause it's another day for you and me in paradise. Oh, think twice, 'cause it's another day for you. My cuties. Nor, that's alright, I'll take the other cuties. Hi! Hello everyone! Happy V-Day! That can come, wait, Happy Valentine's Day! There we go, that's the word. How are you guys? I don't have anything planned. But you want some cake? No, not B-Day! I did change the alert, I think. I'm pretty sure I did, back to the you're awesome! VTuber Day! How are you guys? I hope you're well. I have absolutely no plans. I forgot it was Valentine's Day. Oops. Hang on, let's put my blush on for this. There we go. I forgot it was Valentine's Day. Oops. Ah, shit. It's too early for your cringe. Don't worry. I did. I got some chocolate. I got, what's this brand called? Lindt. They're like, little circle balls. Strawberries and cream, that one. This one is milk chocolate. This one is double chocolate. You guys having a good day? I know that it's still technically not even the 14th for some of you. It'd be still, I mean, actually, the furthest time is 18 hour difference, right? No, 15 hour difference. So I guess technically everyone is officially in the 14th now, but like a lot of people are still sleeping. Because it'd be anywhere between, like, girl. 2
hey,
to
Baz,
5
Hey Baz, be sure not to drop this cake on yourself. Last time was annoying to clean up.
Are you talking about my birthday? Wait a second. Also, hang on, let me move that. I want to move the alert somewhere else. It covers chat, I don't like it. Stream alerts. There. We'll move it down just a little bit. There. Actually, I'll put it in this corner. There we go. Now it's in the other corner. Oh. Now you guys get to see where it goes when you set it off again. Matt, thank you for the 100 bitties, by the way. What are you talking about, my birthday cake? Oh, speaking of birthday cake, don't forget that I was actually gonna make a post tomorrow, like tomorrow afternoon, that there's gonna be, starting tomorrow, there'll be 48 hours left on my merch. So if you have been waiting for the last couple of days to try and like save up some money, you have two more days after today. So you get technically three more days, I guess, but yeah. So I'm gonna make a post about it on Twitter tomorrow, like after work. And then I'll retweet it again and in like the last 12 hours or something like that. All I know is that we opened the store on the 3rd of Feb. So we're closing it 2 weeks from there. So we're closing it on the 17th of Feb. So yeah, you got like 2 days. Yeah. I already got one of everything coming too. I can't wait. Oh, actually, hang on. Did Illusion send me an update? I think Illusion sent me a little just a minor update about merch. They said, I'll update you soon about the first merch send out. We're already starting the preparing of the first batch packing. So they have found a new supplier to send out merch, like a new post company. So they're packing up the first batch and they'll be sending them off. So hopefully for, depending on where you are in the world, you might get it within the next 2 weeks. I know it's taken a while and I deeply apologize. It wasn't Illusion's fault, and it wasn't yours or my fault. It was actually the travel, what do you call them? The post people's fault. They were the ones that pulled out, and Illusion's was like, well, fuck, all right, now I gotta find someone else, so. A bit delayed, but at the end of the day, you were always gonna get your merch, and it's coming soon. Hi, Skeptic, how are you? I get the desk map, but the postage on it triples. Oh, really? Yeah, you know, it's like the items themselves are very good. The items themselves are very well priced. And personally, like in just my, like in my perspective, depending on who it is, I would probably just fork out the postage because it'd be like a one, like with Vebe's Booba mouse pad, actually. So her mouse pad was only like $30, but it same with you, it was double. It was like $30 just to post it. So I paid $60 for that mouse pad when the average person only paid about maybe $40. And this is USD, so technically, on another technicality, I probably paid about $100 for that mouse pad. But I'm only ever gonna buy it once, and I really genuinely enjoy like Vay and stuff like that. So to me, it was worth it, so. Yeah, I know, shipping can really just, it can really put a damper in people's, like, and that's not just for merch, but in just a general sense, like, the postage, in a general sense, can be so mood-killing, because it means that you're not gonna get certain items that you wanted to buy. Merch is never gonna release a Boob mouse pad again. You know, depending on the purchase, depending on the item, sometimes having incredibly limited merch isn't a bad thing. I might do that for something in the future, I don't know what, but like having like a very limited edition item just makes it more rare. I mean, I'm a nobody, so at the end of the day, it probably doesn't matter for me, but like Vay's got like what, between 7,000 and 10,000 viewers averaging, so like she's pretty big, so it'd be more a big deal in her community if you, like, had that limited piece. Limited edition Daki. No, you know what? Honestly, Hans, I need to make my money back on that. That's not limited edition because I need people to buy it so I can make some kind of, like, return. His art is not cheap. I mean, I'm not at all hating artists. They deserve what they charge, but like, it's not cheap. So I need my return. I would need to sell like at least 50 Dakis to like make up what I would on the art. And it's not even the art that's expensive. It's the fact that they just simply double the price for commercial rights. So like, it might only be $500 just to get the art, but it's because they're like, oh, well, you want to sell it. Okay, cool. $500. And you're like, oh, fuck, man. You spent Valentine's Day with your two best friends and partners in crime, Lefty and Righty. How was the gym? Uh-oh, I could hear a cup falling. I think my cat's on the counter. Little fucker. You can see some older creator cups from eBay, like 10 times the original price. Depending on the creator, I could understand it. Like, if they're a really big streamer like Dr. Suspect or Soda Poppin or Shroud or Asmongold, you know, like really big streamers, I could understand that. I can understand why, because it's limited edition and they're never bringing it out again. But yeah, I'm a nobody, so it doesn't really matter. Wait, chat was connecting for a few minutes. Oh no, I'm sorry. I mean, it's good to see you now, Westy. I don't know what's happened though, I apologize. Even though, oh, hang on. Drop frames none, CPU beautiful, FPS 60. Okay, no, it's definitely not my fault. It's on your end, that sucks. Hi, Damon, how you doing? Happy birthday, no, my birthday. My birthday was last week. It was last week. Wait, 12 days ago. It was nearly 2 weeks ago, nearly. But we do have our birthday merch for two more days. So my merch was released for 2 weeks, pre-order for 2 weeks, if anyone's interested. Actually, hey mods, can we, one of you posted the link earlier. Can we just like, actually no, can you actually write it out too and just write, merch pre-orders 2 days remaining or 2 days left, or maybe, I don't know, you guys do it. I fucking suck at this stuff. This is why I suck at this shit, man. Two p.m. Where do you live, Goob? Or Gub? I miss celebrating your birthday. Aw, that's okay. You have the VOD. See, this right here though, honestly, Gubchan, this right here is why I didn't release my Valentine's script. So I was going to release my Valentine's script this morning because it is like, you know, I'm nearly 9 p.m. into Valentine's, right? Like I'm almost the 15th of February. Like my Valentine's Day is over in like literally 3 hours. So I was going to post my Valentine's script on YouTube today. But then I was like, wait, but my 8 a.m. is still gonna be like the day before. So I was like, no, like it's gonna be Valentine's for like 1/8 of the world. So I was like, nah, I'll wait. So I'm gonna post it tomorrow morning. So if you are interested in that, obviously I know that not everyone's into like script reading and role play and all that, and that's totally fine. But for those that are interested, that is already been scheduled for tomorrow, like 8 a.m. So yeah. And I don't know. I'm a bit worried about it because I don't know if it's what you think it would. I don't know if it's what you think it's gonna be. So maybe people might not like it. It's not like bad or anything, but I'll just say now that it's not like, I guess, your typical Valentine's Day script. Like I imagine if you were to go to someone's script for Valentine's, it'd be them like having dinner together. Or maybe at someone's house, or they're hanging out together. Mine is different. It's not bad. I mean, I don't think it's bad. It's based off of true events. Wink, wink. So it gives you an idea what happened, possibly, to me years ago. So I make you sad. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Thanks, Ames. It's supposed to be kinky out. You're gonna have to find out. No. No. A breakup? Oh my god. I didn't say depression. I'm just saying. You'll see. You'll see. You'll see. It's Looter Thriller. Oh my god. No, That's for customs. Actually, I'm not gonna say what the details are because it's like it's between me and the buyer. But I do have a custom. Someone did purchase a custom script off of my Ko-fi, and they gave me the details and the requirements, and I was blushing. I was like, okay. So that'll be very interesting. So I'm gonna write a script around those ideas. Gonna go and find some. Like some sounds to use in the background. I don't think I'm gonna do like raining and stuff like that. Hey, it's on this side. Violin! Texas Beach, no? Or, I don't know, man. I don't know. It works for literally everything else but the subs. I don't know. Texas Beach broke on spoke. Roses are red. Violets are too. Everything is red. Oh god, it's also red. How did this happen? Wait, what? Because I stabbed you to death? How you doing? Thank you so much for the tier 3 for 10 months. Oh my god. How has it almost been a year? What the heck? Thank you. I couldn't think of anything. I did look. A Texas Beach just doesn't work for resubs. It works for bits, but just not resubs. I'll look again, but... Stream... Hi, Danny! Alerts. Alert box settings. Subscriber. Also, did the Texas Beach work for... Yeah, they did work for bits, and they work for donuts too, right? Yeah, look, it's literally enabled. Enable Texas Speech. Texas Speech volume is 75%. It's literally enabled. I don't know. It's just broken. I don't know. I'm sorry, guys. It's just broke. Variation settings. Let me see. Does anyone by any chance have a resub available? If not, it's fine. It's fine. We can wait, but I just turned it off and back on again. You know, sometimes that shit just works. You like turn it off and back on. Maybe that works. Oh, hang on, I don't have that. I don't have it available. Hang on. Oh, you're right, Bloody. Hang on, I'm literally dumb. Hang on. You're right. Hang on. So I turned them all off, and then I just turned them all back on. So that should be okay. Oh! Oh! I don't know if it will work for gifted.
Hello there, good girl.
Is this thing on?
It is on. It works for everything but resub. Community gifts. When a total gift number is set at least one. But how do I guess... I don't know. I'm sorry. I don't know. But correct, thank you for giving a sub though. Cookie, congratulations. Did we refund Correct's 500 kitty point? I didn't have my program open, but it's turned on now, so you can do. There you go. So now you can do. Oh god, there we go. Westy. Mwah! Yeah, did you see? There's like a present on my tentacle for you. All right, let me see the finish line. Gets right down the road. And I'm moving forward. Now, let me try and maybe replay. Alright, let me replay Silence, because Silence is the one that had text on it. It's a Silence one. Just retesting. Nah.
Roses are red, violets are too. Everything is red. Oh god, it's all so red. How did this happen?
Yay! Yay! It was a bit delayed, but yay! Turning it off and back on sometimes works. Woo! Yay! Fuck yeah. Hi, John. How you doing? Jonathan. Hi, hi, hi. Hi, Chow. How are you doing? Hello. It's always after. I thought it finished. It's quite low on my end, so I probably just didn't hear the alert finish. Happy Love Day, you cute fuckers. Oh my god. Want some cake? I have to sleep an hour? Oh. Damn, I'm sorry. I haven't had a dream in a few days, or maybe a couple of weeks. I don't really remember the last time I had a dream, but it's been great. I like not having dreams, because like, does anyone ever have like a dream? Like, it's just so intense, regardless of what it is. Like, it's just such an intense dream. And then you wake up and you just feel exhausted? I had a dream a couple of months back where me and my mom had a really big fight. I don't know why. We just had a big fight and I was like crying and we were yelling at each other and I woke up with like a tear in my eye and I was just so mentally tired. I was like, oh, I don't want to go to work. It felt so real. I mean, I haven't spoken to my mom in like, I don't know, like 5 years, but it was just so real. I was just so exhausted, man. Dreams suck because even if they're a good dream, even if it was like a sex dream or something, you just wake up so tired. And you're like, oh man. But like, you know, these last few weeks, I don't remember having a dream. So when I wake up, I feel like I just wake up to my alarm, you know? It's good. Yeah, Nodders, yeah. I've had different, surely you guys would have had different dreams in the past. But it's just anything. It could be like you hanging out with random people in like a shopping mall and then it just transforms into you being in battle in the fucking 1900s to then after another 5 minutes of what feels like 5 minutes of that dream, you just get teleported to the future and now you're like eating at a restaurant with aliens. Like, anyone ever have those weird dreams where you're just constantly teleporting and doing, you're just in a different scenario and it feels like it only goes for 5 minutes, but like obviously it's a dream, so I don't know, maybe it goes for like a long time. At least Happy understands. You know what, Happy? You and me, homie. Okay, at least Hans, you know what, bloody, you're just weird then. Everyone else has that. Yeah, my dreams will just like, I will quite literally just like teleport all over the place. And the theme just changes every time too. No dreams is probably good. It's good to just rest. Because it means your mind isn't going crazy. If it's 5 minutes, if it's just a dream. That could be so bad. You know what? I don't remember having dreams when I like done the grass, but I sleep really good on it, so it's been a while. Pandy gets it. Not me. Lucy's down. And it kind of feels like home, like we belong. And it kind of feels like home, like we belong. My video? I was just checking the time. of when my next release is in the, yeah, it says here at 8 a.m. So 8 a.m. tomorrow is the next release. I was just looking at that and like it shows me like Feb 15 at 8 a.m. and the angry one is almost at 1,000 views. It's like triple the views of other of everything else. You guys like it when I'm angry? You won't like me when I'm angry. Damn, Gubchan, that sounds horrible. I'm sorry. We love the Sandra. I don't even know if I'm doing it right, honestly. That's my abuse me. Oh my god. Eating lip balm, okay? Absolutely. Make sure you eat the strawberry flavor. I have thought about, I don't know how well it would do or not, because it feels very like every single scriptwriter has done it before. Okay, wow. Well, I am an alien, so there's my forearms. Shit, what was I saying? You interrupted me. I feel like every single ASMR script writing, like, not foreplay, sorry, roleplay, always has some sort of, like, dungeon tied up theme. Like, I do browse YouTube for, like, inspiration when I'm not sure what I want to, like, have. And, there's so many, like, stuck in your basement or, like, you know, trapped in the basement or some shit. And then, like, you hear, like, the chains and all that. And I was like, part of me wants to do it because I could write a good script for it. But also part of me is like, man, it's just, everyone has one. So, I don't know. Of course, watch that one be like the one that blows up or something. I don't have 8 arms. Hi Daytona, how are you? I think everyone likes people angry. I don't like being angry. It wasn't even angry, it was just more like snobby. It was just like, you're late, you know? Don't you think? That's what I mean, it's so popular. That's like, part of me wants to do it because I feel like it is a popular topic, but then part of me is like, man, everyone does it. So it's like, do I even want to do it? Do you know what I mean? I have so many other, like, oh yeah, actually, speaking of, so speaking of this whole entire discussion, I actually wanted to ask this tonight anyways. For those that are on Twitter, I did make a poll about tomorrow's stream. So tomorrow is Wednesday, and I was actually gonna be doing a little bit of my own, so here, there. So I was gonna do like my script reading. It's not gonna be like, it's mainly gonna be me working on my script. So it's not gonna be a really high engaging stream. It's definitely gonna be a very lurker friendly stream, because it's gonna be me writing out scripts, recording, finding the right sounds, and then like timing it and blah blah blah. Yeah, like a work stream, but it is gonna have the very soft tones, the whispers and that sort of stuff. So I was trying to decide of whether or not I wanted to just do it on YouTube and just keep everything ASMR related in that category, and also that way if people do watch the stream, even if lurking, it will technically boost up my watch hours, and I need 4,000 watch hours to like get monetization and blah blah blah. So it would help in that aspect. But yeah, so I made a poll of like, did you guys want to watch it? Like, you know, should I just do it on stream and say like on Twitch and say fuck it, just do it on Twitch, or do I want to do it on YouTube? Oh my god, Chin. it is, what's the, where is the poll? Oh, that's cool. Holy shit. Okay, it's got 52 votes already on it. Goddamn. So apparently, well, 65% people saying keep all ASMR on YouTube, and then 34% people saying live streams go on Twitch. So the reason why I wrote it like that was because all my live stuff is on stream. And then I've got two YouTube channels. One is just my VOD dump. There's nothing good on that one. It's just me dumping my VODs, because VODs get deleted on Twitch after 2 months. So it's just a place to sort of store my memories. So that one doesn't count as much. So that's why it's like all my live stuff happens on stream, like Twitch. But because technically it's going to be like an ASMR stuff, I was like, do I want to do it on YouTube? I don't know, man. I'm sort of tough. Endurance until 4K. Holy crap, that would take way too long. Even if I did like a 3-hour stream tomorrow and 10 of you guys watched, I mean, that's 30 hours. That'd be actually really good. What the fuck? Yo, can at least 10 of you guys come over and just lurk? That would be pretty solid. 30 hours added. That would be a huge boost, actually. Yes, I can actually tell you exactly what it's at now. It's not a lot, because I've only been doing this for 3 weeks. So I need 1,000 subscribers, I'm at 185, and I need 4,000 watched hours in 1 year, in 365 days. So let's just say I get to 3,900 hours, but then the year ticks over, I lose those hours. You know? And I'm only at 117 hours. So 117 hours out of 4,000. Sheesh. If you do an ASMR endurance, I don't know if I can handle it. Well, I mean, no, I won't. Hi, Noomi. Want some cake? Lurkers are heroes who die in the dark. No, it is true. 100%, yeah. There are some people that don't like lurkers because they are like, no, if you're in here, you need to talk. But it's like, if you think about it, there's realistically about, what, maybe 10 of you talk. 1, 2, 3, 4, 10. Yeah, anywhere between like 10 and 12 of you guys like actively talking. But there's like, what, about 40, 50 of you guys in here. So imagine if like the 30 to 40 people were like, well, we're not talking, so we'll just leave. So many streamers would lose more than half of their audience if they did. So don't hate the lurkers. Appreciate them. But at least that way you guys get to sort of see the process of what I go through. And then maybe you guys can give me some... Because I have a lot of ideas. I've got like titles here, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I got 13 titles here, so I got 13 scripts to be written, and I plan on doing at least 3 tomorrow, like pretty much 1 an hour. Write it out, record it, and then I'll edit. Oh shit! What the fuck happened? Hang on, sorry. What the fuck happened? Well, that was weird. Please don't crash again, OBS. I can't handle that shit. You crashed yesterday. Someone say lurker. Hi, watchers! Thank you for the art, by the way. And Kaz. And who was the other one? I think it was like 3 of you guys. Thank you. If everyone is talking, it would be chaos. Lurking can also help reduce streamer stress. I mean, that is very true. I mean, I feel like if you have like around 300 and less, active communities are more appreciated, because, you know, sometimes having like, you know, the dead periods, like, you know, there's like 30 minutes of like pretty much no one talking. It can be very like, what's the word? Like, you feel down about it. Like, you start to feel sad. But like in those big streams that have like Shroud, for example, they have to have slow mode on, or they have to have sub only mode on. Like, they have to. It's just way too fast. And like, I remember I was watching, I think it was Shroud actually. I remember I was watching Shroud. He always has sub mode only on, always. I remember once he was like, you know what? fuck it, we're turning it off. And then he turned it off, and his chat is already insanely fast, right, with sub mode on. He has like 15,000 to 20,000 people watching him. So his chat's already fast as fuck. And then he turned it off. Oh, his chat was zooming, bro. It was so fast. He was just, he laughed. He's like, I can't read. I literally cannot read this. It's too quick. So yeah. So that's why, like, I understand why certain streamers put it on. I know some people hate sub mode only, or they hate follower only. Like, they hate it. And for the most part, I agree. But I think it's very case by case dependent. If you see that that stream is going very quickly already in only sub only mode, it's probably for the best they keep it on, if you know what I'm saying. Or if someone gets like raided, like hate rated or like botted, usually we turn, like, we hardly turn on follower sub only mode here, but mainly we do it if we get like botted and it like spams the chat and they come in here and, like, you know, obviously like some sort of like random copy pasta message. But oh, for sure, skeptic, sure. Yeah. 10-25% of people who do even chat the wrestler. Yeah, 100%, 100%. Yeah, easily. Next chat is the most insane. Really? That's the most you've seen, bloody? Oh, bro, I could literally link you some bigger streamers. Not to say he's not big, but I can link you people that are, like, so much faster than his. You literally sit there and you're like, what? How? And then, like, he'll glance over his chat, he'll look over, and he'll keep playing the game. He pretty much ignores his community, but not in a negative way. He just looks at it, he's like, I can't read it. Anyways, I'm gonna go, like, shoot these bad guys now. It's like, I understand, yeah. I usually, when I go into a stream, I usually chat for like anywhere between like 10 minutes to like half an hour. And then I sort of like go into lurk mode as well. So I like to introduce myself, not introduce myself, but I like to just say hello. So, like, you know, if it's like Vivi, I love Vivi. So I'll go into her stream and I'll be like, hey Vivi. She'll be like, oh my God, Baz, blah, 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 I love you. And I'm like, I love you too. Oh my God. And then, like, after about, you know, 15 or 20 minutes, you probably stop seeing me typing, because, like, I've just, like, obviously I've got it on the top monitor, whilst on the bottom monitor I'm, like, focusing on a game, or I'm, like, recording something, or I'm editing something, or, you know, something like that. So I'm, like, 90% lurker. Yeah. Just go watch an esports tournament with 100k views. Yeah, bruh, nah. Imagine I'm putting stream on. My both of monitors are the same, child. It doesn't matter who I put them on. They're both exactly the same. And I have my monitor split into threes. Like, for those that have like Windows 11, if you like have your mouse near the top of your monitor, like with like a web browser, like it, you can like. And let me just show you. It's probably just me if I just fucking show. I just want to quickly. Oh, there's two of me. But, like, see, here's chat. If I hover my mouse near the top. Oh, it doesn't work with this chat box, does it? It'll work with this one, though. If I do Discord, for example. So there you go. See how it pops up? See? And then I can choose where I want to put it. I usually do this one here in threes. One, two, and three. Like that. Or I can do, like, into fours, because I've got ultra wide. Or I can do like a small one and then a fat one. So usually this is what I have on my top monitor. So, like, I've got chat here and then I've got like my web browser here. And then you got like just easy 50-50 split. Yeah. So, like, I have all these like shortcuts up top. So that's how I sort of divide my top monitor. So I'll have like a stream here. I'll have my Discord here. And then I'll have, I don't know, something else over here. Like my web browser or something. Yeah. Or you can do it in threes. Yeah. So, that's how I sort of, like, organize my stuff when I'm, like, when I'm streaming. That's neat. Yeah, yeah, it's really good. I call Zen, can't keep up with her chat speed, hence TTS more appreciated. See, the one thing that annoys me, Numi, is how people hate on that, though. I 100% understand her point of view because, you know, as a streamer, I mean, I don't have an active stream, and I get it. That's totally fine. Pardon me. But if you're like, if your chat is moving so fast, it is actually nicer to be able to hear someone's reply over trying to read it. Because, like, you're going to miss it, and you have to sit there and scroll up to try and find that message. Like, you're fucked. But if someone just, like, does a quick, you know, 500-bit or 100-bit, whatever their limit is, and they just simply write their message there and just being like, you know, good to be here, thanks for streaming, blah, 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 at least they get to hear it, and it's just, it's a lot more nice. But, again, also, is like, because they're so large, a lot of people could just use and abuse the 100-bit, like mine, for example, so they would technically have to increase it to, like, 500, which is, like, $5, but then people get really, like, what's the word? Like, aggressive? Like, oh, money hungry. Oh, they're only doing it because they want money. It's like, well, no, they physically can't read your fucking chat. It's too fast. So being able to, like, listen to someone's reply is a lot nicer. $3 even, yeah. It's like 3 or 4. Yeah, pretty much, Chin. Yeah, I just have it divided. So my top monitor is usually divided by 3s horizontally. Vertically. And then my bottom monitor is sometimes like just half and half split, depending on what I'm doing. There's only once in my entire streaming in the last 7 years where I actually did have sub-only mode enabled and TTS was a priority. And that was when I was doing Warframe. And I got raided with 17,000 viewers. Or was it more? To 30,000. I don't know. It was a fuckload. It was a fuckload. I was like, I can't. I literally cannot. So we turned it on to like sub-only mode. Or maybe follower-only mode. 5-minute follower maybe? Maybe it was like... It was maybe 30k, yeah. And like we put it to like 5-minute follower-only mode. And then, like, obviously the text-to-speech was just, like, $5 or some shit, whatever it was set to back then. Because I was just like, I can't read this. I can't read it. I mean, look, it was definitely nice. I mean, I've never had that many viewers in my entire... Like, the most I average is what... We usually average between, like, 80 to 100, very game-dependent. Like, I know that we won't be on high tonight because we're not playing a game, and people definitely prefer games in here, which I'm totally okay with. That's what I was saying about doing ASMR also on YouTube, because I know not a lot of people are into it here, like in my community, so. Oh yeah, Fruity's raided me multiple times over the time. Like, she hasn't raided me since my re-debut, because I don't think she remembers who I am. Because I did do an entire rehaul of myself, like I changed my name, I changed literally my identity, let's just say. So, she probably doesn't really remember who I am anymore, which is a little bit sad, but not her fault at all. But yeah, she used to raid me a lot back then, and yeah, it'd be anywhere between like 800 to 2,000 people. Hi, Brian! I remember having a clip or a screenshot of that raid message. Or not the message, the raid, yeah. So many. I don't think I ever want that many viewers though, because it was too much. It was very, very overwhelming. But I also feel like people don't just get that sort of success overnight. I mean, a very, very, very small amount of people genuinely get that amount of success overnight. But I feel like we had this conversation in the past, and I was like, I'm genuinely happy having like 200 to 300 viewers and only like 80 of them talking. Because that way it stops chat from ever having dead periods, but enough to keep conversations flowing and enough to where I can focus on the game for 20 minutes and you guys can still talk amongst yourselves and the chat doesn't die. Does that make sense? I feel like that's a solid, not greedy, but still enough to like make everyone happy sort of amount. Candy-haired lady. Yeah. That was my old model. Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know what, Pinky? I'm actually going to be doing a trip down memory lane next month if you want to tune into that. I'm going to be showing a lot of, like, old clips over the last... Because I've been streaming for 7 years in March. I started back in 2016. So I've been streaming... And you can check my Twitch tracker as proof. Like, I have been streaming... I did have a 7-month break. I did something over those 7 months, and it didn't work out, so I came back. And so I'm back, and so there is a huge break in the Twitch tracker, but yeah, I started back in... 2016. I wanted to ask, well, to be fair, when I first re-debuted Pinky, I did keep it a secret for the first few months because I wanted to forget about it all. Because I didn't have a good experience when I left. But when I came back, I was like, you know what, I want to start fresh and I don't want to talk about it. But then after a few months, I felt okay to talk about it again. Yeah, that's why people have... So I've re-debuted back in June. So we've been June, July, August, September, October, November, December, January, February. So 8 months. We've been streaming for 8 months now as my new model. But some of you guys have like... 9 months, you cheeky fucks, because you guys knew that I was coming back, and so you started subbing early. Yeah, Joe! Yeah, yeah, yeah! What do you prefer, Joe? I was gonna say Jock. That doesn't sound right. Josh. Jochira. But yeah, so we're gonna have like a trip down memory lane. So if anyone ever wants to know what my old models look like, because I had multiple, and I used multiple different models until I found my footing, let's say. So I'm gonna go show you some clips of like different games that I've played, maybe just doing dumb shit. I'm still drastically contemplating whether or not I'm going to show the face cam ones. As of this very moment, I'm probably not going to. Just because self-conscious and all that dumb. But who knows? Maybe after a month and I think about it a little bit more, I might show like a couple face cam ones. We'll see though, we'll see. I just know that there's two reasons why most of VTubers don't show their face. One, people are very mean. And the minute they're like, oh, so that's what you look like? Oh, you're fatter than I thought, or you're uglier than I thought, or you're skinnier than I thought, or oh, I imagined you with blonde hair, I imagined you with brown hair, I imagined you with short hair and long hair.
It's 59 months.
It is. People, hang on 1 second. So people get like very particular about how a person looks. And so when you don't meet their expectations, they leave. Because they're like, oh, okay, well, I thought she was gonna look hotter. I thought she was gonna look different. And then people leave, unfortunately. And two, the mystery. People, like, there's viewers that are very, like, they love the mystery. But the minute the mystery is gone, they're like, oh, okay, well, I don't really care about her anymore. Because, like, I know what she looks like. And then they leave, and then they just leave as well. Like an immersion break, exactly. That mysteriousness is sort of gone and they just don't really care anymore. So that's why I'm still very hesitant to show videos of me. I mean, I've showed a rare photo. I think I've shown you like, what, maybe 2 photos of me? So, also, Anna, thank you for the 59 months! That's such a long time! Thank you! Arigato, Anna! Mwah! Thank you for the 59 months. It's been nice knowing you for, what was that, like, 5? Is that 5 years? 12, 24, 36, 48, 60. Yeah, it's like 5 years. See? Long, long time. Happy Valentine's Day, Kuro. I feel honored to know what you look like. have you been going, actually, in all and everything that... I don't want to, like, obviously say it publicly in case, you know, your personal... This is your personal stuff, so I'm not going to say it. But how are you going with your things, wink, wink? If you know what I'm referring to. That's a fucking hook. That's a Baphomet face reveal. It's always a risk. Yep. People are just so mean. I feel like it's nice to see who's behind the model just to be like, oh, that's what they look like, but with no judgment attached. Like if someone is, you know, it's more like it's nice to see who they look like because you always have this like image of what they look like in your head. And then to see whether or not they meet those expectations. Oh, not expectations is the wrong word. To see if they meet like your what you thought they'd look like. Like when you're reading a book, oh my god, I'm fucking this up so badly. Like when you're reading a book and they're like, oh, character A, you know, is this and that, and you have this image in your head of what they possibly look like. And then when they do like a live action version or they like bring that book into like a movie aspect and then the character's different, you're like, oh man, I kind of imagine the character to have like brown hair instead. Yeah. So for me, it's like, it's nice to see what the VTuber looks like. Just to see what they look like. No judgment attached at all. But obviously, no, not, like, telling everyone that they should. It's just, I can see the appeal behind it. Let me find you on Discord and I'll show you. Oh, nice! I won't recognize your voice anymore. Oh my god. Let's go, queen. I'm just this type, I'm just this type that's curious 24/7. Outside of that, I don't really care about looks. No, exactly. Like, and that's what I always said back to you guys. I'm like, when someone like gives me their real name or someone sends me a photo, it's like, in the nicest way possible, genuinely, I have no offense to be taken. But like, outside of your name, like in the chat, I don't care who you are behind your name. Like, I don't care if you're short or tall or fat or skinny or brown hair, blonde hair, red hair. I don't care. No, bloody fuck's sake. I care about you as the name and how you react and how you are in my stream. That's what I care about. That's not what I mean. Oh, me too. Are you talking about Harry Potter? Yeah, don't worry. We had haters come in last night, Anna. Someone like did like the follow command for like 2.5 years. And they're like, well, good to know that this is no longer a safe place. Like, oh, fuck up. Go away. Shut up. It's 100% a safe space. We accept anybody and everybody in here. If you don't like it, then fuck off, bro. I don't give a shit. Be parasocial. I love you. Holy fuck! You look so different, but like in a good way. I have 2 years. Guess I'm no longer safe. This is the most stupid thing I've ever read. And then someone else, like, and then someone DM'd me and blah blah blah, toxic. One day, absolutely one day. Fuck yeah.
Knows what it's like.
Gotta fix my noise gate. It's cutting in and out again. I have to like turn my noise gate off when I do ASMR. Or did you kind of hear my whispering? A streamer viewers reveal the voice to you? You know what? That's actually a five head. That's five head. I would do that. I'd set like a limit of like a timer, like a stop timer, like on the stream of like 5 minutes or like 3 minutes or something. And like you, like I, you guys are in like a waiting call, like in a waiting room on Discord, and then like I drag you in, like one person at a time. You know what, Joe? I agree. I still hate my voice now. I don't like my voice. I've never liked my voice. People are like, I love it. I'm like, vomiting over here. It's just so low. I hate it. I'm like, I'm not, I wouldn't say I'm a girly girl, but like, my voice doesn't match me. 100% my voice does not match, like, match me. Did that to you last birthday? Wait, what? What happened last birthday? I'm playing once you get a pirate version. Dude, it's so good, Pinky. And as non-binary, it doesn't upset me. See, and it shouldn't. Don't let a small 1% of people ruin your experience in a really, really fun game. Me who loves low, deep voice, I just don't like it because it's so deep. I don't know. I like listen to other VTubers and their voices are so much higher and I'm like, ugh, I'm so jealous. I mean, I could put on a fake voice. I could. I don't want to upkeep that for hours and hours and hours, so. When I heard your voice, I was like, yep, that voice fits. Nah. I can pull off deep singing. Hi, Gojo! Happy Valentine's! They all put on fake? I know some VTubers that put on a fake voice, yes. I'm not gonna say who, because it's their personal thingy, but I do know some that use a high, like a high pitch. But like the mass majority of girls just have a really nice voice. Yeah, no, I definitely don't want like anime girl high. No, definitely not. No. But I guess in the plus side, at least I can pull off the deep Onne San stuff and Ada is a lot better, huh? Like, I'm working with someone new. Someone new is at my work. They started a couple of days ago. And they sound so nice. Like, their voice is just like a pitch higher. So it's like just a nicer high pitch voice. I'm like, fuck. I work with like 99% men and there's finally this lady and she sounds so nice and she's so pretty and I'm like, man, I always feel like the ugly one in the friend group, you know what I mean? Always. I've always felt like the ugly one in the friend group. Bloody! Inkorone. Arara. Grabbing sustenance. Ah, なるほど. Go eat some food. Apparently I've got cake. And some chocolate-covered strawberries. And some cookies. Welcome, Captain. Daisumi. Oh my god, I almost read this Daisuki. I was like, oh my god, your name is Love? Yeah, for the most part, Joe, I don't know if I've ever really met a toxic VTuber. Like, all jokes aside, like, I feel like 99% of VTubers that I've come across have always just been very nice, welcoming, wholesome. Like, we're just here to vibe. Oh, I remember Puds. Yeah, I remember Puds. It is! Oh, Daisumi! Oh, I know Daisuki! Yakuza, Daisumi! don't think the new girl at work could do an Ada as great. Oh god, you don't. Well, you don't know that. She could. LF sees me ruined by my tears. Nah, don't cry. Celebrate with friends. That's what I do. You don't have to celebrate Valentine's with a lover. You just celebrate with your friends. Did you get chocolate at work? No. Why would I? I have my own chocolate. Ada. Yes, I can't do it. Do you imagine? You get some people that do like low into high. Like a hada. But I go from I don't know what I do. What do I do? Hada. Monotone, just monotone. Monotone as fuck. I like sad music though. Pressing like. I do have some hashtag sponsored Rogue, my three arms. Rogue. Not energy, but hydration fruit punch flavor. Hashtag sponsored. You guys should buy it. It's really delicious and yummy. And 20% off. Dude, I want to be a VA so badly, Anna. I feel like I really could do it well. Here, give me a line. Let me see. Let me look one. Evil villain female villain line. Be aware of pretty faces that you find. A pretty face can hide an evil mind. I don't know if you could hear that. I don't know if my noise gate picked that up or not, but yeah. Emma! Emma's the final boss model. I was jealous. Dude, I was like, I wish I had her model, man. I could totally pull off final boss evil, like... ASMR villain Baz. You know what? We could probably write up a script like that. Let me write it on my sticky note. Hang on. Evil villain. I don't know what the theme would be, but figure it out. KDA villain cover, bro. That would be so slap. Okay, hiccup. Let me have a look. What is that? It's been a while since I've listened to like any sort of KDA stuff. Okay. That was my music. 11 million. 76 million. Okay, well, it must be this one. Holy shit. Oh no, I've heard it. Take it to the grave, I'm a ghost. I know I can be so cold. In the dark. Where I like to keep my heart. Like to catch you way off guard. How's that go? I'll stay deep inside your brain. I don't know. Take you somewhere. I'd have to learn it. Ooh, time to roll the dice. You know I'm your type. Time to risk my life. How's it go? How's this go? Time to roll the dice. You know I like that. Oh, I like that part though. Time to risk my life, not afraid to die. That was good. Yeah, I don't know it, but yeah, I'll have to learn it. Hi, Captain. Hi. New cover. You know, maybe. I'd have to find instrumentals. I'd have to find. Well, I'd have to get art made. Oh man, I'm gonna have to like commission art for this because like you could not have a KDA related art for this. She's in. I don't have it. No, I'm not. Yeah, it's just it's the League of Legends stuff. Yeah, I know their other one. I've been playing a buttload of League lately. Damn, son, you fucked up. Can you play the K-pop song, Never... Oh, shut the fuck up, buddy, I swear to God. Are you practicing? Not really I only just heard of it now. Everyone's saying that my voice would suit it well because I've got a deep voice. All up on your head, do just what I said. I'm a straight up villain, yeah, no feeling. But I'm dead, hear my voice up in your head, watch it fill you full of dread till you go. Is it really a surprise if I'm playing with your mind, and I'll treat you like a prize and I throw you to the side? Am I really that bad? I love to make you mad and happy when you said only care about a bit. They're not really showing what Evelyn's outfit is, so like I could get like I can get like art made with that clothing. So deep inside your brain and take you somewhere far away. Risk my life, not afraid to die. Make you cry, have to put a price. All up on your head. Do just what I said. I'm a straight up villain. Okay. Dude, KDA is amazing though. People are right. Wait, I've been both mods gone? Let's start a riot. Oh, never mind, he's back. You fucking lied to me! Damn. The fuck you lying? Why you always lying? Scatter! Run! Hide! Yes. I really do. Oh, guess what? I fucked up today. So, do you guys remember my friend, the one that cut her hand, that went to the hospital, then I hung out, like, I stayed in the hospital till 3 a.m. with her, and then, like, she took me out to lunch a few days later, like, a week later she took me to lunch, yeah. So I tried to surprise her, and I know where she lives, or at least I maybe thought I did, so I, bought some flowers for her. And I wrote Be My Valentine on it with some vegan, because she's vegan. And I couldn't find vegan chocolate, so I found, like, vegan, gummy fruits. And I put them, like, on her doorstep because she wasn't home. Like, I knocked on the door and she didn't answer. So I just was like, oh, okay, fuck. So I left them there. And I think I might have left them at the wrong house because she didn't text me. So I think I just gave a random person flowers and some vegan gummy bears. Well, gummy fruits. No, because I couldn't find plain dark chocolate. They were all like chocolate with this, chocolate with that. It was just, there was nothing plain. I didn't steal the food, bloody. It was left at my doorstep, just like the flowers. I thought chocolate is already vegan unless you count eggs being added. No, chocolate is far from vegan. No. Chocolate consists like milk and stuff, man. Milk products and everything. Fuck no. Dark chocolate is the closest thing, but you have to be careful what they put into it. It's like if it's just pure downright dark chocolate, yes, but a lot of places nowadays have like marble dark chocolate. So it's like dark chocolate with like marbling of like milk chocolate and white chocolate in the middle, or dark chocolate with like a cream, like a strawberry cream in it, or like a hazelnut cream. So they have, because it has cream in it, cream has milk, blah blah blah. It was really difficult to find like vegan sweets. I did try though. I tried my hardest to find something for her, but I couldn't. So I found like like gummy fruits. So I bought two bags of those instead. I spent like $30. And I think I gave it to someone else. I'm sad. Could have spent that on Genshin. Fuck. Wait, I forgot that Bazzy was gonna snipe a stream. Gorilla? There's a brand called Not Nomo. Oh, I don't know where that is here. Oh my god, what did you add? Chocolates! Ah. Just a short one. I'm gonna be ending in about an hour. It was just meant to be a nice, short and sweet one. Only about 2 hours. Just a cute little one to say happy Valentine's Day and hang out with you guys for a little bit. Because I literally forgot, man. I forgot it was Valentine's Day. I'm gonna be honest with you. I forgot. I mean, I worked all day and then I came home and finished off my scripts. Well, some scripts. Dan, hello. That was yesterday. It is in 2 hours. It will be. It's almost 10 p.m. for me. So in just over 2 hours, it'll be yesterday. Does Valentine's Day hold any significance to any single Pringles? Absolutely. Yeah, for Anna, Valentine's was yesterday. Not for me. So anyone that is just tuning in, I am releasing my Valentine's exclusive script on YouTube tomorrow morning, my 8 p.m. So in about 10 hours from right now. Whatever time it is for you, this very moment, count forward 10 hours, and that's roughly when it's going to get released. It's nothing special, it's nothing crazy. I don't know, people probably won't like it, I don't fucking know. But you know, it's gonna be there. Have a good day at work, anime. Thank you for coming in. Thank you. Mom! Hi! Hi! Thank you for the 8 months! Gato! Hi! Thank you. How are you doing? 8 month renals. Oh my god. Time is going so fast. It's crazy to think that, like, it has almost been a year since, like, we came back. Like, it's just like, where did the last 8 months go? It does not feel like it's been 8 months. It really doesn't. It feels like it's been, like, 3 months. You know what I mean? Just so fast. I know, it's going so quick. Releasing an anime. Me? No. I just do like scripts. Short scripts, like between 5 and 8 minute scripts. Try 5 years, try 7. Oh, you know, we like anime in here. We like anime. Aw, oh, thank you, Crow. Thank you. I know, it's just gone so fast. It's ridiculous. Name five animes? Well, Inuyasha is my favorite. Then there's Naruto. Then there's Bleach. Then there is, well, One Piece, One Punch Man, Tokyo Ghoul. Oh, what was that anime with those three girls, those high school girls? I always, Asobe Asobe is another one. Shit, what was one with the manga books? Miraku-chan, I love Miraku-chan. That was like, I think I named like 8 or 9 there. Asobe Asobe was so funny. It was so stupid. It was so funny. I loved it. Black Bible. Haven't heard of that one. What's the show with the high school girls? Do you know? Do you have any idea how little that narrows it down? Actually, true. I didn't think of it like that. Actually, you're not wrong. No, I meant, okay, have you seen Asobe Asobe? I'm probably pronouncing it incorrectly. But it's just, it's like three high school girls or maybe middle school girls. And it's just stupid. It's literally, there's no plot. It's just it's the most dumbest shit, but it's so funny. That's what I was trying to think of. But yeah, I didn't even like click. Yeah, true. Every anime is based around high school. It's because like in Japanese or just like in anime culture, like apparently high school is meant to be like the best time of your life. So they like to really focus on like pre-working times, because like once you start working, it's all about like work, and people become, you know, tired, depressed, busy, and it's just not as enjoyable compared to like hanging out with your friends and going to the mall and, you know, meeting boys and girls. So it's like, yeah, apparently it's like the prime years, so that's why a lot of animes are based around that high school time zone or time frame. Sorry. The animations were so good in that anime, in Asobe. It was just dumb. Like, the butt when she slaps her ass and it just jig. Oh my god, man. That show had me in tears too, Ham. I was literally crying in some of those episodes. I was like, bro, I cannot. This is just amazing. No worries, Happy. Thank you for hanging out with us while you could. I appreciate it. Thank you. Have a good sleep and happy Valentine's Day. Something ass of high school girls. You have to watch it to know what I mean. Come on, Mung. You have to know. It was funny. That's all I'm going to say. It was very funny. When I used to actively watch anime, nowadays I spend most of my time with JRPGs. Yeah, that's fair though. I'm definitely more of like a gamer than I am a show watcher, like TVs or movies, because with games you can just like pause at any time, get up and you know, come back and just pick up where you left off. Or you could literally log off for 4 hours, come back and pick up where you left off. But you can't really do that with a movie. You can't just like 45 minutes into a movie, just pause it, turn it off, come back after 2 days and continue it. Like, you do you know what I mean? Like, you have to finish the movie. TV shows are better because they're in significantly reduced time frames. Like, a movie is anywhere between 1.5 to 2 hours long, but like a TV show is only 40 minutes, and then an anime is even less. Anime is only averaging about 20 minutes long. So they're more easier to like just watch two episodes, maybe three episodes, and then just turn it off and then come back after a couple of days. But like movies and TV shows are just a lot more difficult for me. So I prefer just to like play games or watch things in shorter time frames. So, which makes me sad because I really do love watching movies. Usually when I'm not streaming, so like tonight, for example, I was actually gonna watch. I'm fucked up. We already know this, and I like my murder-related documentaries and missing people because I'm fucked up like that. I was gonna watch a movie that just came out. They're based on like true stories, like the Believe Me with the girl that got abducted, but no one believed her. The girl in the basement when she was like kidnapped for 20 plus years. Level 16, oh no, not that one. That one was just some fiction, but that one was actually a really good one. There's a new one that just came out too. A new one that just, yeah. Hans! Sorry, I didn't mean to yell at you. I'm sorry. Hans! There's this YouTube channel that I'm subscribed to. And I binged all of their stuff. And I'm like sitting here, like rocking back and forth in fetal position, waiting for the next episode to come out. It's called Unseen. Here, let me just link it straight to you. These are all like either unsolved mysteries or people like, you know, survivors that solve their own mysteries, not mysteries, but like their own they escaped from like, you know, being in prison for 20 years. People that were supposed to be dead or not dead. Like, oh. I binged all of it. I literally binged all of it. I think they only have about maybe 20 videos, but I went ham. I was just like fucking Like the one with Elizabeth Smart. Oh my god, that made me fucking cry, dude. Have you seen the movie based on that? There's actually a movie based on Elizabeth Smart. It's like a 2-hour movie, and they apparently she directed it. Makes sense because it was like it's her story, so she directed it. But like watching that movie made me like cringe in like that way of the way that what happened to her was just like, ugh, like how could you do that to a kid? Like, oh my god, bro. And I'm just like the satisfaction of these people getting away, like these girls and boys escaping and just getting justice is so. I love it. I love it so much. You know what though, Captain? After binging all of these shows, or they're not TV shows, they're real. The documentary is probably the better word to say. After binging all of these documentaries and watching these documentary movies on people's lives, It makes me more aware of my surroundings. Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm just that much more cautious because you don't think of this stuff until it happens. You don't think you're gonna get kidnapped. You don't think that you're gonna get raped or murdered do you know what I mean? Like, you don't think it's gonna happen to you until it happens. So all of this stuff. Now, like when I'm like walking to my car, for example, I make sure my keys are out of my pocket and in my hands before I'm in my car. So I'm not sitting there shuffling in my handbag looking for my car keys, right? I make sure that like when I'm home, I make sure that my garage door is actually fully closed before I turn off my car in case someone tries to, you know, jump in. At least I can reverse out of my garage instead of like trying to restart my ignition. It's just little things like that that make me that much more cautious and aware of my, like, just my surroundings and stuff like that. So, I mean, you can, Hamdan. Unfortunately, you can. There's been, unfortunately, a lot of little boys that have been raped. That is... Seeing the strawberries on the side makes my mouth water. I know, look how delicious they are. I always drive the car unlocked. Same. My car is never unlocked. I've seen people just like, you know, like at the stoplight, like their car is still running. They're just holding their brake because the light is red. And someone just runs up and pulls them out of the car. Yeah, it's crazy. It's crazy. It happened to you, Hans? Oh, but your door was locked. Oh, thank fuck. Oh my god. It's scary. It's so scary. So like obviously I feel very, very, very sad that this happens to people. But at the same time, I'm a little bit not grateful, because it is definitely the wrong descriptive word, but I am grateful that their experience has allowed me to be more cautious of my surroundings. Because that's usually what they want. Like usually, like when they make their stories publicly known, it's because they want to spread the awareness, and it works. Otherwise, they wouldn't make a documentary. You know what I mean? Thank you, Saya! Thank you. How are you? Happy Valentine's Day. No, I'm really glad that Australia doesn't have... I mean, I don't really get into the topic of guns because I know that can bring out the worst in people, but I'm just going to leave it at I'm glad we don't have them here, and that's about it. There's actually... You know what, Hans? Was it you that doesn't like... No, someone in here doesn't like TikTok, and that's totally fine, by the way. But TikTok has been pushing a lot of, like, documentaries on my feed lately. Where is it? And I found this documentary of, like... I'm trying to find it. I liked it. I just couldn't find it now. Fuck, I like too many things. It's ridiculous. I'm gonna have to find it. Oh, I think I... Okay, no, I did see it. I'm just trying to find the name of it. I'm gonna watch it probably on the week... Like, on Thursday night. It's called... The Girl Who Escaped, the Kara Robinson story. So I've been like getting a whole... Really, have you, Hans? Oh, dude, I'm getting like so many like documentary related movies and stuff. It's I love it. Like, it's totally catered to what I'm into, so I love it. The Girl Who Escaped, the Kara Robinson. So yeah, then full story movie trailer. So they made a movie based on what happened to her getting kidnapped and how she escaped. So I'm gonna actually watch that one on probably Thursday. I love food. God damn, your TikTok always get me with those catchy songs. wait, which one, Metal? Metal, hi! How are you, Metal? Happy Valentine's Day. I hope you're well. I miss you. I hope you're well. Wait, what do the emotes do? I don't even know what the emotes do. Doing better? I'm glad to hear. I'm doing okay. I'm not really doing much. I'm still just hanging out and vibing. You know what, Chin? Mood. It'd be like that as you get older. You sort of like get that realization. Like, I don't use social media except for Twitter, just for streaming, and that's it. Like, technically, yes, I have like an Instagram and a TikTok account, but I don't like post on them. Like, I've been trying to post on it just for my YouTube and that, like, promoting YouTube, but I'm not using it to like look for things, if that makes sense. But I don't even have social media for my IRL stuff. Hey, I'm not even kidding. Like, I don't have an Instagram for my personal life or a Twitter for my personal life. Like, I don't have that stuff, actually. So, like, when my friend's like, what's your Instagram? I'm like, Baz. I don't post my personal life on social media. Yeah. And not that I don't have anything against it. I just don't. Oh, okay, son. I get what you mean. Yeah. It's specifically use Twitter to monitor you girls and, well, some NSFs. Yeah, of course you do. No, see, I only use Twitter regularly to post Twitch stuff. I post on Instagram for my ASMR YouTube stuff. So just like a picture of my thumbnail with like the, literally the link, and that's honestly it. That's it. That's literally all I use. Fuck. My friends got quite annoyed with me at one point. They're like, so can you, like, use social media? I was like, no. I'm not against it, I just have nothing to post on there. My life is pretty fucking boring, dude. I have a really boring life. Metal. I love getting like cooking stuff as well. Hi, Rickroll. How you doing? Twitter's just for VTubers and anime titties. No, honestly, yeah. Honestly, same. Twitter's just for my for my streams and like people that I follow that are also VTubers. Like you're 100% same. Same bloody. And the occasional game. Like, if a new game comes out, I tend to follow that, too. I love your art, Kaz. That wasn't retweeted, was like, 2018? Yo, retweet! That's it. Oh, actually, speaking of, I think I need to still update my panels with, like, the newest links. Like, I haven't even posted on. Hang on, let me have a look. Oh, no. Oh, never mind. Yeah, I think I delivered the flowers to the wrong house. Fuck. Was her house. Oh, that makes me so sad. Damn. Makes me sad. Hi, Makari! How you doing, beautiful? Hope you're well. I think you'll pick up Blue Protocol. What's that? I don't even know what it is. Happy Valentine's Day, Grim! Happy Valentine's Day, Makari! Try to be mutual focused at Twitter and not to have too many non-mutuals I follow. That's fair, that's fair. Usually when you follow too many people and then they start retweeting other things, it starts to flood your feed. Like, with obviously all due respect to, like, you know, content creators out there, I'm not like shitting on anyone, so please don't take it in that aspect, but I was following, I feel like too many people that were retweeting stuff that made me feel uncomfortable. Mainly, I'm just gonna be honest, a lot of like porn. It was like people that was like liking and retweeting like other, like, you know, naked people, and I was like, I just don't want that on my feed. I don't want that. So I had to unfollow people that I like because of what they were retweeting. And it made me sad because, like, I didn't want to unfollow them, but I also didn't want to see a bunch of dildos and stuff like that constantly flooding my Twitter feed. I just want a bunch of VTubers. Like, I don't want anything else. And art, obviously, and art. VTubers and art, it's like, mwah, chef's kiss. That's all I care about. Hey, no worries, Dasumi. Have a good night. Happy Valentine's Day. We'll see you next time. Me too, Grim. Follow a streamer for their cute model, then they start retweeting. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. Like, I rarely post NSF art of my model. But one, I do spoiler it, so that way people have to click it to actually see the nude. And two, not me, my model. And two, I don't post it often. I don't post that sort of stuff often. Yeah, honestly, yeah. I forgot to, like, I was at work. This is, I think it was like 2 days ago. I was at work. No, wait, Tuesday. So I think it was Friday. So it was last week. I like opened up my phone. I was going through Discord. I was just scrolling. And then obviously I go through, cause like, you know how like when you have unread messages inside like a Discord, like a category, it's like highlighted white text. And then once you've read it, the text goes gray. So there's a bunch of like highlighted white text on my Discord because you guys are very active in there. Bless your souls. So I was like, oh, I'll just go through and see what my tomos are up to, clicking through them all. And then without realizing, I clicked the NSFW one. And I was like in a group with people like at work. And it was just like tits and vaginas. And I'm like, ugh! Scrolling. And I was like, oh, if I just scroll up, you won't see it. But it was in the NSF tab, so I'm scrolling up to more NSF art. And I was like, oh, fuck. And like, I panicked. My heart was like, doki doki. So yeah, I know exclusively that I do not open the NSF tab. Hey, Maple. Happy Valentine's Day. I hope you're doing well. Are you okay? I'm fine. Yeah. Yeah. It was so awkward because like I work in like a construction type setting where there's like 90% men and then like 10% women. Like there's not a lot of women in my workplace. So like it's just more awkward when like I have like, you know, 8 or 9 guys like sort of sitting in like our little area, like we sit under this dome area, and then just see my phone and just looking at titties like oh fuck man. Hey, what's up Brighton, how you doing? Hope you're well. No, I'm definitely not okay. Every day you're right, I'm breaking. Look, see. Every day they break more and more. Every day. I'm not okay. Okay. Maybe one day we can fix me. Thank you. Oh my god! Dude, actually, well, you know what? They did kind of Makari. So, when my phone, my background of my phone is my model. So I was like opening up apps, and then obviously I closed the apps down, and then my background was like showing, right? So, someone like had looked over my shoulder, and they thought it was, fuck, what game was it? Was it League? No, it wasn't League. They didn't, shit, I forgot the name. I forgot the name that they said of the game. But they asked me if I played a specific game. And I was like, oh, no, I haven't played that before. Like, okay, because your background looks like the character. Let's just say, for example, let's just say that it was Genshin. Just as an example. Or let's just say Honkai, because I don't play Honkai Impact, right? So they'd be like, oh, do you play Honkai? I'd be like, what? No. They're like, oh, okay, your character on your phone just kind of looks like it. So they have peeked at my phone before because, like, again, we're sitting in, like, a sort of huddle. And, yeah, like, they saw my background. But it was my model, which is, like, Pog. So they have peeked over a bit, but definitely not the VTuber. It's just more, like, the game. Titties! Exactly, Matt. Hey, happy Valentine's Day, Nelix! Hope you're well. How are you? Hi, Gift! How you doing? I plan on getting into Honkai once I'm done with store hangout quests. Nah, I don't have any intentions of playing Honkai. Genshin will be the only gacha game that I will play. Because it does require a lot of commitment to grind for the free-related stuff to be able to get purchased items, but for free. Wishes. Primos. Like, whatever the primo equivalent is in Honkai, I just don't have the time to sit there and grind 2 games. as a free-to-play gamer, so definitely not. I feel for your coworker, my eyes tend to wander, so sometimes I look at the screens of others. Joe, you're naughty. You know, that's probably another little thing as well. Yeah, I agree, Matt. I'm not huge, like, I'm nothing against it, but yeah, definitely more of like, I'd rather be the one controlling the character, like Genshin or Hogwarts or Apex or MMOs. So I like to control my character, so. You just got home, Metal? Oh, you know what? Go have a shower, relax, have some food. Remember the days of our youth when we could play four MMOs at once? No. That'd be great. I plan to play Honkai Star Rail? Nah. Pay to play? No! My bank account! I can't afford it. I don't mind Final Fantasy, but I think, yeah, I'm definitely not vibing the pay-to-play games. If it's a free-to-play game with paid elements, like a gacha game where the game itself is free and you can pay to get certain things, I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. Like Apex too. Like Apex is free, but you have the ability to buy skins and stuff. That's totally fine. But like World of Warcraft and Final Fantasy, it's like, I don't want to have to sit there and pay $20 a month to play your game. Because like, if I can't play because, I don't know, fucking my job gets in the way, I'm punished. I can't play this game that I enjoy playing because I'm not giving you fucking money. So, yeah. Not gonna play Star Rail? No, I'm not running, no. I did play Final Fantasy Online for like 20 hours. So I only played for like 1 month and then I unsubbed. Yeah, that's why I don't think I'll like it, Hans. True, Joe, you're not wrong. I played WoW for like 10 years or something. Good night, Anna. It's so late for you. Go get some sleep. Thank you for coming in. Thank you for the resub and happy Valentine's Day. Have you heard of the free expanded trial of the critically acclaimed? No, I have not. I have not. Oh, you're not gonna sleep? Oh my god, your sleep schedule's fucked. I have a very, very good sleep schedule. For a streamer and a VTuber, I have a very, very solid sleep schedule. Because I have to work. If I didn't work, it'd be fucked. Run, where am I gonna find time? I hardly play games when I'm not streaming. Hardly. I sort of like when I come home from work, I'll have a shower and I'll like, you know, prep. If I like, depending on what I'm having for dinner, I'll prep that. I'll like play with my kitties for a little bit. I'll come to my computer and I might play a game for about an hour, maybe two. And then I stream, right? So like, in like a 24-hour day, I stream for 3 hours. And I game for maybe an hour before I start stream. So I might only get 4 hours of gaming in a day. Max. Oh, is it silent? Okay, I don't know these memes. I'm sorry. I'm uncultured. I'm sorry. I'm unbased. No, my kit. No, 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 my kitties. No, no, K-I-T-T-I-E-S. Kitties, cats. Meow, meow, meow. My kitties, my two cats. Oh my god, not my kitties, not my titties, but my kitties. Oh my fuck. Thank you, Ames. Thank you. No. No, I don't want my titties when I get home. Oh, fucking hell. No, I have the door closed today. They were annoying me. Because their bells are so fucking annoying. I heard him, like, drop a cup. I think Arlo jumped on the counter and knocked over one of the cups. It was luckily just a plastic cup, but I heard it. Oh, shit. What is that picture? I want to see what picture that is. Which one is this picture? Aw, they're still so cute. I'll have to, like, make a post on Twitter with a better photo when they're, like, sleeping together side by side. They're so cute. No, I do like it. It's a cute photo. It just doesn't show off, like, their patterns as well. Because they've got beautiful patterns, so. You know, I probably do. I just haven't made a post on Twitter for a little bit. I'm a bit behind and stuff. Oh, that one is a pretty bad photo, though. It was, like, a very pixely photo, because it was really dark in my room, so. I don't want to ignore it. The trial is 100% free. It would take... What would it take for you to try it at least one stream? Oh, man, I don't know. I would need to see gameplay of it. I would need to see, like, what it's about before I just jump into a game like that. $1,000. Yeah, I'm also a fucking... I'm a whore for money, so, you know. I'll take $1,000. What a bloody set. Oh, fuck. Yes, Grim, 100%. We're all suckers. Good night, kiddo. Have a good one. Thank you for coming in. Happy Valentine's Day. I need games that don't require commitment. That's the problem. Because I work 40 hours a week. If not more. So by the time that, like... By the time that I'm home and just, like, chilling out, I'm just so tired. Do you know what I mean? So, like, games that require a lot of commitment is just, like, not on my, like, radar at the moment. Games that I can take my time. That's why I like Genshin. Because it's not... It's not a competitive, it's not multiplayer, it's not like I'm gonna fall behind because I didn't play for 3 days. Do you know what I mean? It's single player, it's at my own pace, and it's good. And that's why I also like Hogwarts, for example, or any sort of like single player RPG I love. So I loved The Witcher. It was like my own pace, and I, you know, play it when I can. Same with the Resident Evil series, same with the Tomb Raider series. Stray, which we are going to play on Saturday. Friday. Just those sort of games are definitely more my vibe just because of how busy I am. Way back when I was streaming more full-time before I needed to get a job, I would play, like, way more competitive games because I had the time to do it. I would push and push and grind to get into, like, platinum and diamond in games, and I would do multiplayer games like MMOs and stuff because I had the time to put into it, but I just don't have that anymore. Remake soon. Ooh, wait, did I play number four? I don't remember. Nekopara. Never even heard of that. I don't know what that is. Let me open up Steam. Where's Steam? I didn't play Ford. Which one have I? Let me see. Resident Evil. Let me go to my completed tab. Alright. I have played number two. I've got 10 hours in number two. Apparently I haven't played number three. I've played Biohazard, so I've played Resident Evil 7, and I've played Resident Evil Village. So I've played Village, Biohazard, and 2. I swear I thought I played another one. Have I only ever played those three? Hmm. What happened to your Twitter feed, Grim? Oh no. I'm hyped to a RE4 remake and it looks really good. Ooh. Is it in my wishlist already? Let me have a look. Last of Us Part 1 is in my wishlist. Resident Evil 4, yeah, there it is. March, 24th of March. Okay, so it's gonna come out next month. Okay, cool. Yeah, it's in my wish list, so I'll get notified when it releases. Cool. Cool, cool. Good night, Joe. Thank you for coming and hanging out with us. Happy Valentine's Day. Persona 4 and 5 are amazing for this. Yakuza series, Breath of the Wild sequel. Oh, I did play Breath of the Wild. But I don't have a Switch anymore. Unfortunately, I had to sell my Switch and all of my belongings with it because I really needed money for bills. So I don't have my Switch anymore. But I did play Breath of the Wild. I don't have Yakuza's and I don't have Personas. If you don't plan on getting it, I'm gonna gift it for you. Do you mean if I do plan on it? Resident Evil 4? Oh, I have every intention of wanting- like, I enjoyed number 2, I enjoyed 7 and 8, so I do have every intent of playing Resident Evil 4 Remake, it's not out yet, so. Pretty much, Hans. I feel like you guys know me better than myself, y'all like, if she likes it, if she doesn't like it. Metal Gear. No, the other game that I want to play is... So, the games that I have on my list to be played is Dead Space, Doom Eternal, because we did Doom 2016. So, Dead Space, Doom Eternal, God of War, and then Halo. Stray, we're gonna... Oh, it's actually 10:30, so I'm gonna end now anyways. But yeah, Stray is one that we're finished. Hang on, where's my... Do I have it on the server? I think I did, right? Yeah, so that's the plan for this week. So, Friday. Friday, we're gonna... So we already... We're about... Chat said I'm about 50%. 50%, right? I'm about 50% done with Stray, so we're gonna finish it on Friday. Even if I have to do an endurance, I'll stay up until I beat the game. Hans. Have you ever played Blizzard's RTS? What? StarCraft 2? Yes. Yes. Have you planned to play Leon's story? No, I really haven't. Is it really that drastically different? playing Leon's side versus Claire's side. I don't know if it was that bad of a difference. Who played straight? Wait, who played straight? How much more does Baz need to beat the game? I'm about 50% Chin, is what I was told. So I passed like the sewer area, and that's all. If you watch the Stray VOD, like near the end of the Stray VOD, Chin, that should give you an indicator of where I left off. Yeah, or where I stopped playing. Oh, is he the main character? Fuck, okay, maybe I might have to do that then. Okay, I did not know that. Don't want you to, like, go without sleep streaming to clear the game. No, because it's on a Friday, so it's fine. Fridays and Saturdays, I can stay up late because I don't work weekends, so it's totally fine. It's during the week, like tonight, where I do like to finish after, like between 2 to 3 hours, because I do have to get up at 6 a.m. for work, so. I'd recommend playing Leon's campaign. Oh, fuck, okay. I have to play it soon then, since number 4 is coming out next month. Yeah, I tried Monster Hunter. It was okay. It was okay. Nothing against it. Let me just put it into my favorites, because like my favorites on my desktop, or sorry, in my Steam library are the games that I want to beat, or games that I just enjoy playing. So like, for example, Apex is in my favorites because it's a continual game, but so I got like Dead Space, Doom, God of War, Hades, Halo, Hogwarts, Resident Evil 2, I have to put it in there for Leon's side, and then Stray. So once I finish Stray, that'll get removed and put down into the completed tab. Also, guys, I am going to end, but just as a quick little reminder, Saturday coming, so Saturday this week, we are going to be doing community game night in the Discord, in the lobby chat. If you look at the pinned messages in lobby, or somewhere around there, somewhere like in that top bar, we have a thread for games that we can play on the night. So if you have any suggestions, it's a thread button. Thank you, guys. So click the thread button and write down any suggestions that you want. And then that way, as we approach Saturday, we can like download and install the games that we're gonna play for Saturday. Yeah, Chin. Just ask the mods or anyone else and they can probably help you out. And then on Friday, we are gonna do the kitty game. So we're gonna play Stray on Friday and I'm gonna beat it. So that's happening. Now tomorrow. So tomorrow I'm doing... It's not going to be a typical, not study stream, but it's like a working stream. So tomorrow, I'm actually going to be writing my scripts and recording myself with the sound effects and whatnot. And then I'm going to download the VOD and then I'm just going to like crop it and edit it, you know, for that stuff. But... yeah, it will be a very hardcore lurky stream because, like, obviously, whilst I'm, like... I mean, you guys are welcome to throw me suggestions as I'm writing scripts. I'm not opposed to it. But, like, as I'm recording myself and reading it and putting my emotions into it, I will be not replying to chat. And I will have my alerts muted and that sort of stuff. Because this is just going to help me upload videos to YouTube... without taking more of my time away, because I don't have a lot of spare time. As you guys know, I'm very, very busy. So if I just dedicate a stream to it, that was my fucking keyboard. If I dedicate a stream to it, then that means on my nights that I'm not streaming, like Tuesdays and Thursdays, I can genuinely just sit back, relax, and just watch a show or play a game or something. I'm highly thinking I'm gonna do it on YouTube. And there's two reasons for YouTube. One, I like to keep my gaming and my ASMR on separate channels because I know that people that watch gaming don't like ASMR and people that watch ASMR maybe aren't into gaming. So I don't really want the two to cross over too much. And two, I need 4,000 watched hours on YouTube in order for them to give me monetization. And I know that if you stream to YouTube, let's say I stream for 3 hours and there's 10 of you watching for the whole duration, that's 30 hours like that, just added onto my watch time. So it's, if I do that regularly, it's gonna really like push up my watched hours, and that way I can get monetized sooner than planned, right? So I'm 90% sure that I'm going to stream on YouTube tomorrow for only ASMR stuff, not gaming stuff. I haven't streamed to YouTube with OBS, so I'm gonna have to like set it up and do all that stuff. So I'll try and put it like up a waiting room tonight and just see how I go. Look, if worse comes to worse and it doesn't work out, I'll see you on Twitch. Gonna be stuck with YouTube shitty emotes. Yeah, I know, YouTube is not great for streaming. I get it. Trust bloody, I get it. It's only to help me push my watched hours, because once I get the 4,000, then I get my monetization, and then that's all that really matters, so don't worry. Yeah, it will be on the ASMR channel, yes, not my VODs channel, correct. So it's the Baz ASMR, the one that has like the 10 uploads on it. Makes sense to do ASMR content including, yeah, exactly. That's exactly my thought process, Chin. Keep all of my YouTube ASMR content separate to my gaming stuff. That's my plan anyways. But yeah, we'll see how that goes. Hey, what's up, you? How you doing? Have a Valentine's Day. Thank you. Don't need a significant other to enjoy it. Treat yourself. Exactly. Well, I decided to stream tonight to my Tomos. I was like, you know, I'll hang out with you guys tonight for Valentine's Day. I am heading out, though, because it is 10:30, and I wanted to, like, I only wanted a short stream tonight. Nothing too crazy, nothing too long. Short and simple, down to the, I can't think of the word, fuck's sake. Blondie, hi! Hello, beautiful. How are you? Happy Valentine's. I miss your face. Hope you're well. Oh, yeah. My weekday streams are very short, unfortunately. I have to get up at 6 a.m. for work every day, so I can't stream long anymore. Not like it used to be, sadly. Sag. But, my weekend streams go for much longer. My weekends go for way, way, way longer, so don't worry. They usually go by double. If I stream about 3 hours on a weekday, then they go between 5 to 6 hours on a weekend, so. Lucky 6 a.m. Oof. Oh, that makes me sad if you have to wake up earlier than 6. But thank you. No, thank you, Brian. Thank you. Hey, don't worry about it, Brian. We're here just to hang out, have fun, and just enjoy our time. When did you get your new outfit? I already submitted all of my PNG files. I submitted a bunch of like different poses and different items, like to show like the design of the clothing and all that. I've submitted all of it to Mama, and I'm simply waiting for them to go through my request form and approve it, which shouldn't be too long from now. But obviously getting a second outfit's gonna take a hell of a long time, so I'm hoping I can have my second outfit before my 1 year re-debut, which is in June. So maybe in about 4 or 5 months, maybe. Maybe 4 months. You have to go at 3 a.m.? Fuck, I'm sorry. Can I get a sneak peek? Maybe. Oh, you cheeky cheeky. Maybe. Good night, Hans! Mwah! Happy Valentine's! Can I get two? No. Not even my mods know what it looks like. Legit, not even the mods. The only people that know about it are the girls in my waifu Discord. Because obviously, like, we show each other all of our different models and stuff, and... That's literally it. Yeah, that's literally it. Yeah, dude, honestly, you, yeah, being able to, like, sleep in on the weekends makes me appreciate sleep-ins now. Blondie isn't trustworthy? Mood. Yeah, I get it. Yeah, Blondie's a little fuck. I get it. Alright. We're gonna go see Vivi. Vivi is doing some tarot reading. Fuck, I haven't done tarot cards in ages myself. We'll have to get back into that one day, too. Man, I just have so... Oh, I just don't have time. Oh my god. I miss having, like, time. I miss it. No, it's not dead. Definitely not dead. I just don't have time, man. I'm just struggling to keep up. That's all it is. It's too much things I want to do, but I just don't have the time to do what I want to do. Unfortunate. Yeah, I might have to start something even less than that, so maybe even just once a month. It's just because there's so many games coming out as well that I want to play, and obviously I want to beat some of these games before new games come out. Like, I really want to play, like, you know, like, I want to play the God of War, and I want to play Dead Space and stuff like that. So it's like, they're just... And, like, obviously, I'm always a gamer first, right? So games, for me, take priority to, like, other content. Does that make sense? So, yeah. But anyways, yeah, we're gonna go say hi to Vivi. Thank you guys for coming in and hanging out with me tonight. I know it's a short one. It was always going to be a short one. But I hope you guys have a wonderful day. Don't feel sad that if you don't have someone to spend Valentine's Day with. At least you get to spend it with me. And just, you know, give something to your friends. You don't need to have a partner to enjoy Valentine's Day. Like, I gave flowers to my... Well, I mean, I sent it to the wrong house, so... Literally hate myself, but it's the thought of me sending my flowers to my friend. I gave my friend flowers, but I delivered it to the wrong house because I'm an idiot. But you know what? A stranger got flowers, so they probably opened up their front door and was super happy when they saw it, so. Yo, nice, bloody. Yeah, I accidentally put the flowers on someone else's house, so I was really sad. Flowers cost me fucking $20, dude. Flowers are expensive. Then I bought her, like, vegan lollies. Spent like $30 on a fucking stranger today. Ugh, frustrating. It's the exactly. True, Nelix. I look like Billie Eilish. Oh my god, maybe with... No, I do. You're cute, though. Thanks, peep. They're allergic. Oh, fuck. Fuck. All right. I'm gonna go, though. I love you guys. Thank you again so, so, so much. I appreciate it. I'll see you guys tomorrow, okay? We're gonna try to do the stream on YouTube. And if it does fail, then I'll just meet you guys here instead. I'll try and get a waiting room up and running as well, and then I'll make sure I post links there. My tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. is gonna be the Valentine's edition script, so enjoy that. Hopefully you guys like it. I write all the scripts myself, so this script is actually based off an IRL experience, so hopefully it's a little bit more personal, like, meaningful for you. And then, yeah, see you guys tomorrow night. So enjoy the stuff coming up. Yay! Alright, let's go see Vivi. Let's see. It's Vividly. Sorry, Vividly. Her name is Vivi, but it's Vividly Vivi. She got so many V's and I's in her name, it throws me off. Is the icon the same? Okay, yeah. As long as the profile picture matches, it's fine. No, it's not a sad script. It's a good script. But it'll probably make you sad in the beginning. DM me, Blondie, I miss your face. I love you. I love you. I love all of you. Good night, my beautiful Tomos. Daisuki deyo. Otsu chat. Oyasumi. Bye-bye. I love you. I'll see you guys tomorrow night. Mwah! And happy Valentine's Day!